And
joining us, he's the chairman of the House Intel Committee. Devin Nunes is with us. Congressman, good to see you again. Thanks for being with us. Let's first get your take on the firing of the deputy FBI director, Andrew McCabe, and the statement of the attorney general.
Well, as you know, we've had the FBI under investigation by our committee for a long time on FISA abuse and other matters. So it doesn't surprise me that Mr. McCabe went. However, our investigation still is ongoing. Mr. McCabe still owes us answers no matter where he's working. And eventually he's going to have to come forward and provide those answers.
Yeah. Well, one of the things, he's going to have to provide the answers, but I really see, he even seemed to, in his statement, implicate James Comey. Did you catch that as well, that he knew about the leaks in the media?
Yeah, I mean, that's why this is becoming so difficult, right? There's so many witnesses now who have testimony all over the map, which is why I think you continue to see this call for somehow DOJ and FBI are going to have somebody who can actually investigate them and put all of this out there, you know, because we're continuing to have problems in Congress just getting the information that we need. The latest example of that, Sean, was the text messages that emerged on Friday night. We did not have those text messages, and we had asked for those text messages back in October, November, and December. So it's very difficult for Congress to get to the bottom of this. I mean, every day we find out something new. However, I think at this point there's so many crimes that have to be investigated. They need to get somebody over there who's gonna run a thorough investigation and maybe work with the IG when that report comes out.
And do we know when we're finally getting this IG report? I mean, I keep hearing one former head of the FBI or top FBI official said it is pure TNT.
Yeah, I have not seen it. I have not been briefed by Mr. Horowitz. That is really under the jurisdiction of the Judiciary Committee and the Oversight Committee. However, they do have a lot of, the IG does have a lot of information that my committee is very interested in when it comes to what we continue to look at and call it FISA abuse.
Yeah. You know, James Kallstrom has been a longtime friend of this program, and he actually made this statement. Former assistant FBI director, high-ranking people throughout the government had a plot to protect Hillary Clinton from being indicted. In your opinion, based on what we know, and 18 U.S.C. 793, which says you cannot mishandle classified information, similarly, you cannot destroy it. Then, of course, you have subpoenaed emails that are deleted, acid wash, bleach pit, busting up devices with hammers. Do you have any doubt in your mind that those are crimes?
Well, as you know, our committee continues to look at conspiracy. We're looking at obstruction. We're looking at misleading Congress. And also there's the statute in the Civil Rights Code that involves, I think, abuse of power and using your position to go after someone personally. Actually, Greg Jarrett, I've seen him on your show many times. He's talked about this this provision. And so there's many crimes that have to be looked at, you know, but I keep reminding people, Congress cannot prosecute. All we can do is make a referral to the Justice Department. And then the challenge is who are we going to refer it to? Because as you know, we don't know who over at the Justice Department is involved in this, who would have to be recuse themselves because of their involvement or their knowledge of what happened over the last few years.
Yeah, I mean, now the public, I mean, this poll that I referred to in the last segment about the deep state is very telling. I want to ask you about two issues involving James Comey. The president pointed out a testimony that James Comey was under oath to Senator Graham. Have you ever been an anonymous source or known someone else to be an anonymous source? He said, never, no. Do we now know that's not true with the leak that we know that he was involved in?
Well, you bring up a very valid point. So somebody is lying, right? So we don't know who, but those stories don't jive. Now, I'm sure this is all out there now, they're going to try to start to cover up their tracks, but this is why we have to have them back in to answer these questions. You know, we still have a questionnaire that's out that they have not responded to. That's unacceptable. You know, we needed to know when exactly did they learn that the dossier was paid for by the Democratic Party and the Hillary Clinton campaign.
We do have evidence of what Hillary Clinton did as it relates to the email server. We do have evidence that, in fact, an exoneration was written before an investigation. We do have evidence that Hillary fixed a primary, and we do have evidence that she paid for a phony dossier, funneling money through a law firm, and that that dossier that she paid for was then used to get and obtain a FISA warrant with great omissions and lies on four separate occasions to FISA judges. Am I wrong on any of that?
No, I think that's exactly right. And so what we're trying to determine here is who was involved at the FBI and the Department of Justice that made these decisions to move forward, not only to make the decisions on what to do with the Clinton campaign, but then that's what Mr. Gowdy and Mr. Goodlatte are investigating, and the IG, Mr. Horowitz. But we're also trying to look at, who made this decision to open up this investigation, and why was it done? Because it doesn't appear to me like they had any credible evidence to open up a counterintelligence investigation. And that's what we just can't have in this country, where you have political dirt that's paid for by one political party and used against another, especially using our foreign intelligence capabilities. It just can't happen in this country.
It's illegal. The comments seem very arrogant from both James Comey and Brennan this weekend as it relates to the president. It seems personal, and it seems abusively biased. What is your reaction to their comments?
Yeah, I saw those comments over the weekend, and I was really quite surprised, because, and this is again not helping where we have to go in this country, right? The American people expect the intelligence agencies not to be political. And what you're seeing is the comments that are coming out from the highest levels of the intelligence agencies from the last administration are quite alarming. I mean, this is just way out of character. I mean, you don't see former CIA directors making those types of comments like Mr. Brennan made over the weekend. I don't know why he did it. Maybe he should retract it, but we'll see.
All right. Well, it seems what James Kallstrom said, that high-ranking people throughout the government had a plot to protect Hillary from being indicted, and I would add, undermining Donald Trump. Mr. Chairman, thank you, sir, for being with us. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Sean.
And joining us now with reaction, Michelle Malkin, Investigates host on CRTV. Michelle Malkin, Fox News, national security strategist, former deputy assistant to the president, Sebastian Gorka. Michelle, your reaction to all of this, and this is really just the tip of the iceberg, McCabe.
It is. The stench emanating from the top echelons of the FBI are beyond fetid. I mean, this is the malodorous muck of the deep state swamp. And as desperate as the desperation media is, Sean, there is nothing they can do to cover it up. They'll keep repeating the same tired, false talking points about this being some sort of partisan witch hunt on the part of the Trump administration. That's pure psychological projection. And you can't hide the fact that it was career FBI people and an Obama appointee in Michael Horowitz. So you've got the IG within the Justice Department and the Office of Professional Responsibility that signed off on this firing last Friday. It has nothing to do, as you said, Sean, with Donald Trump. And I think you're absolutely right. You've been saying it for a long time that this is the tip of the iceberg. And I have to say that as a matter of historical context, this did not just come out of nowhere. I reported over the last 8 years about how the Obama administration, and particularly people in the Justice Department, thwarted at every turn Inspector General's investigations. It happened at Justice. It happened in the EPA, Interior, TARP, every single one of these civilian agencies. And so you add the national security implications and dangers of the hijacking of our intelligence agencies. And yes, we are in the midst of a constitutional crisis.
And it's to undermine a duly elected president and to assist a felon lawbreaker and literally exonerate somebody who committed many laws. That is a constitutional crisis. Let me go to Dr. Gorka. You have Rice, you have Clapper, you have Brennan, you have Comey, you have Page, you have Strzok, you have Loretta Lynch. You have the Obama administration top down.
Absolutely.
Deep state.
let's remember, you know, this individual, Andy McCabe, he's just a small part of a massive conspiracy. And again, the OPR, it sounds very anodyne, the Office of Professional Responsibility, that's the IAD of the FBI. That's the Internal Affairs Division, and they said this guy cannot get his pension. That is a massive blow, and it's just the beginning. But now comes the real test, Sean. Now AG Sessions has to clean the stables.
Special counsel.
Right.
Special counsel. All right, guys, you've been amazing. Thank you all.